हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड इक्वेशंस, केमिस्ट्री क्लास 10 सीबीएसई। स्टूडेंट्स, टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस चैप्टर वी आर डिस्कसिंग सम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ लैंग्वेज ऑफ केमिस्ट्री। इन टुडेस क्लास वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द केमिकल क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मैटर। बट बिफोर एक्सप्लेन दिस केमिकल क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मैटर, वी फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड द टर्म केमिकल फॉर्मूला। स्टूडेंट्स, ए केमिकल फॉर्मूला इज सिंपली सिंबॉलिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द केमिकल कंपोजिशन ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट पार्टिकल्स ऑफ ए मैटर। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वेन वी राइट H2O, इट शोज दैट ईच पार्टिकल ऑफ वाटर इज कंपोज ऑफ टू एटम ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एंड वन एटम ऑफ ऑक्सीजन। This H2O is representing the one particle of water. In the same way, when we write N2, this is representing nitrogen gas. It says that each particle of nitrogen gas is composed of two atoms of nitrogen. That is a molecule. In the same way, NaCl is representing that the common salt is composed of sodium and chlorine atom. Calcium carbonate, that is a marble, is composed of calcium, carbon and oxygen. It means this is a short form of representing a chemical substances which show also the composition of that matter. Now let's start our main topic, today's main topic, the chemical classification of matter. Students, you know that every matter is composed of constituent particles, and these constituent particles are called chemicals. And these chemicals may be atom, molecules or ions. So on the basis of the chemical composition of these constituent particles, matter can be classified into two categories, pure matter and impure matter. Pure matter is also known as substances, and impure matter is also known as mixture. The matter in which the constituent particles have similar chemical compositions means they are composed of same kind of atoms. All the constituent particles are composed of same kind of atoms. Then the matter is called pure matter or substances. And if the constituent particles have different chemical composition, means the particles of that matter have different atoms, then the matter is called impure matter or mixtures. You can see the examples of the pure matter. For example, iron. In the iron, each constituent particles is composed of same type of atom, that is Fe. It means all particles are same kind, and this is the pure matter. So iron comes in pure matter. In the same way, when we see neon gas, each particle of neon gas constituted by the neon atoms. In the case of nitrogen gas, you can see that each particle, constituent particle, is composed of two atoms of nitrogen. That is again pure matter. If we see hydrogen gas, each particle is composed of two atoms of hydrogen. If we see water, all particles of water is composed of two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. It means the all constituent particles of water have same chemical composition. It means it is a pure. In the same way, ammonia composed of NH3, carbon dioxide is composed of CO2, and sulfur dioxide is composed of SO2. Students, these type of materials, you can see that all the constituent particles are composed of only one type of atom. That is iron atom, that is neon atom, this is nitrogen atom, this is a hydrogen atom. These type of pure substances are called elements, and elements are the simplest form of the material. In these cases, you can see that the constituent particles have similar composition, but they are composed of different types of atoms, which are chemically bonded to each other in a fixed ratio. These type of pure substances are called compounds. That means compounds are composed of different kind of atoms, and the elements are composed of only one type of atom. When the different elements combine chemically together, then they form compound. Elements, different elements combine to form compounds. In case of impure metal or mixtures, when two or more different pure substances are mixed to each other, then the new matter form is called impure matter or mixtures. It means they have different kind of particles which have different chemical compositions. For example, the most common example is the air. In the air, you can see that air is a mixture of gases. Because it is composed of nitrogen gas, it is composed of oxygen gas, it is composed of peroxide, water vapor, and many more other gases are also present. It means air is composed of different kind of particles having different chemical composition. So it is a mixture. In the same way, when we dissolve common salt in the water, so common salt is a pure substance and water is again pure substance. But when we mix each other, then the resultant new matter have the particles of water, particles of sodium ion, particles of chloride ions. In this case, this become a mixture, different kind of particles. Stainless steel, which is an alloy. Alloy is the mixture of metals. And the name of this metal is stainless steel because it's composed of iron, chromium and nickel. Again, there are different type of particles are there, having different chemical compositions, different atoms. So, this is not a pure, this is actually impure. It means pure are composed of same kind of particles and impure are composed of different kind of particles having different chemical compositions. Students, the maximum materials around us are actually mixtures. So, daily life we are dealing like wood, soil, paper, plastic, the food, milk, medicines, paints, polishes. These are all some examples of the mixtures. Students, elements again divided into metals and non-metals on the basis of their physical properties, which will we discuss in later in chapter 3, metals and non-metals. Let's see some examples of metals. That is the sodium, this is the potassium, this is the aluminium, this is the iron, this is mercury, this is zinc, platinum, gold, silver, copper. This is magnesium, calcium, barium, beryllium, chromium, manganese, this is cobalt, this is nickel, this is gallium. You can see that these all metals are composed of only one type of atoms. And this is their chemical formula, or we can say symbolic representation of these metals. In case of non-metals, we take examples of hydrogen gas, H2. We can take examples of carbon. This is nitrogen gas, this is oxygen gas, this is fluorine, this is chlorine, this is bromine, which is liquid at room temperature. This is iodine, which is solid at room temperature. This is sulfur, which consists of 8 atoms in one particle. This is octatomic. This is solid at room temperature. This is phosphorus, composed of 4 atoms of phosphorus. This is solid at room temperature. Helium, neon, argon, these are all noble gases. And some more examples are also there. So you can see that these all composed of only one type of atoms. So these are all elements. Now, come on the second part of pure matter, which is composed of different types of atoms. And they are again divided into two categories, covalent compounds and ion compounds. When atoms react to each other, when different atoms react to each other, combine to each other, by sharing of electrons, then the compounds are formed called covalent compounds. And when the different atoms combining by transferring of the electrons, then the compounds are formed called ionic compounds. The properties of these compounds we will discuss in chapter carbon and its compounds and metals and non-metals when we discuss the covalent and ionic compounds. Let's see some examples of covalent compounds. That is the water, H2, this is carbon dioxide, this is hydrogen chloride, this is glucose C6H12O6, this is sulfur dioxide, this is nitrogen dioxide, this is ammonia molecule, this is methane, this is acetic acid, this is ethanol, this is carbon monoxide gas, and many more examples we can give for covalent compounds. Let's take some examples of ionic compounds like sodium chloride, zinc chloride, lead nitrate, ferrous sulfate, copper sulfate, ammonium chloride, barium sulfate, calcium carbonate, potassium nitrate. We know that impure or mixtures are composed of different kind of particles. If these all particles are uniformly mixed to each other, it means the composition of the mixture is uniform. That is called homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture are also known as solutions. And if the composition of the mixtures is not uniform, that is called heterogeneous mixtures. Examples of homogeneous mixture are air, sugar solution in water, and alloys. And many more examples are also there. And examples of heterogeneous mixture are suspensions. For example, soil, when we dissolve soil in water, that becomes suspension. If we dissolve oil in water, that is called emulsion. That is an example of heterogeneous mixture. And milk is also, which is a colloid, are also examples of heterogeneous mixture. So students, in this lecture we have understood the matter around us exists in three chemical forms. That is the elements, compounds and mixtures. In which the element is the simplest form of the material. This is the basic form of the material. We can say that these are the alphabets of the language of chemistry. These elements combine to form compounds. And different elements or different compounds or element and compounds when mixed to each other, physically mixed to each other, then they form mixtures. In the next lecture, we will discuss how we can make the chemical formula and their chemical name. Thank you.